out. So we basically get to that town and... What's going on down there? Look at the town! Docking bay. Sid, Mid, I've got something to tell you. Save your breath. We saw the ruins float through our telescope. The Earth crystal is in it. What? The crystal is what made it float. The machine had been turned off to keep it from breaking, but the Earth crystal kept the town afloat. But it was stopped when the crystal cracked. We've got to hurry! Someone started it up again! You don't think father? Never!
Never!
Did father? No way! How can we get up that high? With this. Adamantite, if we reinforce the ship with this, it will fly higher. I knew that. I remember seeing some in the meteorite I wrote in on. You sure? What, you don't believe me? But your memory. I remembered the adamantite, didn't I? Better see it with me own eyes. We'll stay and get things ready. Hurry and bring us back some adamantites. Seems simple enough. So we find one of these crashed meteors, and... Let's see now. In there. Nothing could possibly go wrong with this. That's it! How about it? Pretty good memory, huh? How did an amnesiac like you know? Whoa, ha ha ha! Something is in here. Watch out! Oh, snap. Steal! Couldn't steal. Couldn't steal.
Hmm.
Oh, disgusting. Stole hard body. White magic, one person. That did very little damage. That works on the bosses, huh? Okay. Turtle shell. Drink in battle raises defense. Oh, nothing. Apparently nothing's in there. And the others rest up. Oh, we didn't need the end. Airship was done. It's done! That was fast. After liftoff, press the X button to fly higher. Now you can get to the floating ruins, right? Well, it's not that easy. You better take a look at this. Unless we disable all of their cannons, we won't be able to get in. The book says the cannons are extremely powerful. But we have to try. What are y'all worrying about? It's just a couple of measly cannons. Thanks, Sid. Mid, now let's get to that crystal before it's too late. Now we shove off. We'll save state. Please die. Whew, that was... Received crits. Couple of hard bodies. More battles. Stop burning me! Not that easy, though. So now I gotta get the cannons on this side. That's the last one. Drummer. So, the first one was weird, and these are pretty basic. So now the cannons are down. We should be able to board. Yep. So all of the cannons. What? Wait, what about that? Huge. Well, trouble us greatly. I'm a beard. Then you have to actually trigger the battle. Sensor cannon activated. Oh. Safety lock off. Planning to overload, I think. Rabu. Hit that thing with everything we got. Fire! And we're all gonna die. Alright, 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, time magic helps here, I guess. So... time and red magic combo... burn them ethers! Sensor cannon activated. Lock off. hell? I wish I could hit everyone with regen. Should give us more time to zap it dead. Survive the next shot. And then fire all the bolts we can into it. Nothing to steal. What? Barrel pressure rising. Bolt two. Have to give some consideration to what party members are or what classes we're fighting bosses with. Can we make it through that opening? It's worth a try. Do it! Encounters. Gotta love it. Runkanite. Strange. 350 experience. Thank you. I'm gonna want that treasure chest. We have to be careful, cause we're fighting battles. First strike, steal. Seems like a good outcome. Tonic. Oh, we're still in the back row. Okay, I don't know if another boss is forthcoming soon. Experience for one enemy. Elixir. So that should be, 235. Need more rust. Dirt boom. Oh my god. These enemies don't seem too hard, at least. until now. That's pretty rough. That's not great. Someone's got a hit, right? Get a couple bugs on. Man, I'm lost. Well, I'm not lost. I'm just kind of annoyed that the game didn't really let us rest and save anywhere after that boss. Lamia! I guess I might as well equip the secret ability since I don't have any key locks. Gold shield. Okay, that answers that question. Oh my god. This could be bad. Well, not that bad, apparently. We do know the toad spell. Which is very helpful in reversing toad. Yeah, there it is, black magic. There we go. That's what I was looking for. Ooh, attempt. Back. And we'll save. Oh, that only restored 100. Yeah, we got a more powerful cottage, too. Oh, no, I'll just use another tent. It's not a big... I have, like, 30 of them, so it's not a big deal. You okay? Closer we to leveling up. Trust those stone masks not to really screw us up. To not really screw us up. I assume that's a room we're getting to. Couldn't steal it. Oh my god, this is really confusing. Not entirely sure what the right direction is. Are you freaking kidding me? Okay. down that one goes. Battle after battle after battle. Let's try it for it on him. Might as well try every possible. Combination of magic and well, like. Mithril shield. So down here. Is this the general direction we need to go? Oh, I went too quick. I think it just takes us back though. Fire seems to work reasonably well too. We can get potions from these guys sometimes. We'll be right back. Received caution. Oh my god, this encounter rate. It's awful. That bow accuracy, awful. Alright, we're level 22. Yeah, this is just a giant maze. Insta-kill would be nice there. Oh, they have ethers. Not bad. Hey, Maelstrom. How you doing? With the sword, you can't attack the Hydra, the Hydra. Gallo's using the something called the Death Axe. It's dropped by the Bio Soldiers. Good man, how am I doing? It is becoming somewhat apparent to me that I'm not going to be finishing this area today in all likelihood. Death Sickle. On the island where you get the airship, the island, like, next to that, there's, like, bio-soldiers, and if you steal from them, you can get that Death Sickle, and sometimes they even drop it when you, defeat them in battle as well. Aqua-os. I think bolts is the way to go here. Okay, bolt is not the way to go. starts! I can't run from it. That is just disgusting. No! Oh man, I'm gonna die. I am gonna die. Gal is the only one doing appreciable damage to him, and... Throw a phoenix down at him, you say. Just to put Rena ran way out of sync with our levels. I think I would have preferred to die there. Game and its mini bosses, but let me tell you, this game and its mini bosses, rather. We don't want to go there yet. I want to actually finish exploring this area. So now thanks to this game's trolling, Rena is now like 1,000 experience points out of sync with my party. The Death Sickle does really good damage, but it's kind of an annoyance when you don't really have control over whether death triggers or not. I feel like we've already... Game too loud. I knew I would have forgotten to do something, and that would be to turn the game sound down when I switch games. Yeah. Can I just run? I need to quit very, very soon, so this is just getting really annoying. I thought I'd be able to finish this area, but... That's a negatory. It's a racing simulator. Kind of like Football Manager. It's like Football Manager where you control the drivers, but not directly. Yeah, you're basically a team principal. You have to decide how to basically spend the money the team earns, whether it's to buy better drivers, improve the team, improve the components, improve headquarters. Really? One step away from safely getting to the next floor. One thing I don't like about this game is how it will throw unusually tough enemies at you almost as a troll. It's like you have a leveling system that determines, you know, how powerful you are for fighting most of the regular enemies, but then there's like an enemy or two in specific areas that are like way stronger or require a special strategy to defeat. It's a really good way to just make you want to throw your controller across the room. Skull Eater, yeah. Harpy, and then there's one inside of the desert that devastates you as well. We should just attempt to do the job here. Basically all the way. I really do need to quit now though.